find it on our parish website, so that you can know what is happening here at St. Mary Parish. With the start of school right around the corner, now is a good time to make sure that all your safe environment clearances are up to date if you are planning on volunteering or coaching for Sea Life. Please contact Sammy in the Parish Office Center to see if you are here for the upcoming year. Today is the 17th Sunday in ordinary time. This Mass is being offered for Robert A. Carney and Patricia A. Marcini, requested by the Carney family. Our celebrant is Monsignor Mentor. Our entrance is number 538, Singing to the Mountains, number 538.
Rejoice. protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is whole. Bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and God, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that have it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And their sin is so great that it must go down and see whether or not their actions fully correspond to the cry against them that comes to me. I mean to find out. While Abraham's visitors walked on farther toward Sodom, the Lord remained standing before Abraham. Then Abraham drew nearer and said, "Will you sweep away the innocent with the guilty? Suppose there were 50 innocent people in the city. Would you wipe out the place rather than spare it for the sake of 50 innocent people within it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to make the innocent die and the guilty, so that the innocent and the guilty would be treated alike. Should not the judge of all the world act with justice?" The Lord replied, "If I find 50 innocent people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Abraham spoke up again, "See how I am presuming to speak to my Lord, though I am but dust and ashes. What if there are 5 less than 50 innocent people? Will you destroy the whole city because of those 5? He answered, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." But Abraham persisted, saying, "What if only 40 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it for the sake of the 40. Then Abraham said, "Let not my Lord grow impatient if I go on. What if only 30 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it if I can find the 30 there." Still Abraham went on, "Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? The Lord answered, "I will not destroy it for the sake of the 20. But he still persisted, "Please, let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10 there?" He replied, "For the sake of those 10, I will not destroy it." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, you were buried with him in baptism, in which you were also raised with him through faith in the power of God, who raised him from the dead. And even when you were dead in transgressions and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he brought you to life along with him, having forgiven all of our transgressions, obliterating the bond against us with its legal claims, which was opposed to us. He also removed it from our midst, nailing it to the cross. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And he said to them, suppose one of you has a friend to whom he goes at midnight and says, friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived at my house from a journey, and I have nothing to offer. And he says in reply from within, do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children and I are already in bed. I cannot get up to give you anything. I tell you, if he does not get up to give the visitor the loaves because of their friendship, he will get up to give him whatever he needs because of his perseverance. And I tell you, ask, and you will receive. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds, and the one who knocks, the door will be opened. What father among you would hand his son a steak when he asks for a fish? Or hand him a scorpion when he asks for an egg? If you then, who are wicked, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I suspect pretty much all of us have had the experience of having to ask someone to do us a favor, that is, whether it's to drive us somewhere or lend us something. And when that happens, we know that there's some people that we may ask who will probably say yes, but they may get a difficult experience. They're going to say yes, but they make it clear from their body language, from their tone, from their expression, that they're saying yes, but they're really not happy.
They're going to do this, but you better think twice before you ask again for them to do you a favor. On the other hand, you know, there's some people that we can go to, and we know that our request is going to inconvenience them. But they don't show it at all. They seem genuinely happy to be able to do something for us, glad to be able to help. Well, in the readings this morning, we see two different approaches to prayer that reflects that kind of mindset. In the first reading, we hear about Abraham going to God in prayer, praying for God to spare Sodom and Gomorrah. But Abraham's approach to prayer is a kind of let's make a deal approach. I'm going to negotiate with God and try to get the best deal I can get. And so it's almost as if Abraham's buying a used car. He starts out by saying, well, if you can just find 90 good people in the town, you spare the town. And he works his way down, and in the end, he thought he got a good deal. He said, if there's only just 10 people, just 10 good people in that town, you'll spare the town. And so Abraham finishes thinking that he negotiated with God this great deal. We find out later in the book of Genesis, there aren't even 10 good people in the town. And so the town gets destroyed anyway. But Abraham's approach to God is that he thinks he has to wheel and deal with God, as if God is reluctant to do what is right, as if God is reluctant to give Abraham what he needs. And so Abraham thinks that he knows best, and he has to negotiate with God. And sometimes I think in our prayer, we may take that same kind of approach. We go to God in prayer, and we're telling God, well, God, if you only let this happen, I'll make sure I don't miss Mass. Or if you only let this happen, I'll say a rosary every day. But that's not a good way of praying. And we're not really here to negotiate with God, but instead, Jesus points us to the best way of prayer, and that is in the gospel, where Jesus tells us that when we pray, we should approach God recognizing that God is our loving Father, that God is anxious to hear our prayers. He's eager to do what is best for us, that we don't have to control God into doing something. We have to try to negotiate with God, but rather, we go to God as trusting children to a loving Father, knowing that God wants to answer our prayers, can hear our prayers, and loves us deeply. And so when we go to prayer in God, we don't want to negotiate, but rather we can go trusting and lovingly to God and present God with our needs, talk to God about the difficulties we're facing in life, and entrust them to God's care. At the same time, looking at God as a loving Father also reminds us, however, that God as a loving Father is also a wise Father. Knowing that same way in normal course of life, sometimes children, small children, will ask their fathers for things that really aren't good for them. And so sometimes the father has to point them in a different direction. And the same thing is true in our relationship with God, our Heavenly Father. That God in his wisdom, that God in his love, knows what is best for us better than we know it for ourselves. And so certainly God wants us to come to him with our problems, with our concerns, with our petitions. But ultimately, our prayer to God has to be the prayer that Jesus says in the gospel. And that is, Heavenly Father, I present you these needs. I'm asking you, I'm petitioning, begging you for these things. But at the end of the day, Father, your kingdom come. Your will be done. And we say that because we trust that God is a wise and loving Father. That he only knows what is best. That we're not trying to impose our will upon him, but rather we're asking God to help us to accept his will in our lives. And so today we ask God to help us to become better prayers. Not going to God as if we need to control and negotiate with him, but rather always approach God in our prayers as he is, as our loving and wise Father.
Yes, could you please stand now and stand in the trust? I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was the incarnate Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he is a true Father, not a Father. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
You will come again, Lord, to judge the living and dead, and the kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from Father and Son, who with the Father and Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess on baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With trust in God's love and God's wisdom, we present the Heavenly Father with our needs and petitions.
For the Pilgrim Church on earth, may God help us to readily forgive others and joyfully seek His kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials and policymakers, may God grant them integrity and protect them. All who are vulnerable, especially the poor, the elderly, and the unborn, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those trapped in sin or addiction, may God give them faith and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our family of faith, may the Lord's faithfulness help us continue in prayer, trusting God to answer in His time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the recently departed, especially Peter Casaza, Father of parishioners Lyndon Demples and Christopher Casaza, and parishioner Katherine Murphy, may God reward them with everlasting life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us come in faith to the Lord who graciously hears and answers our prayers, especially for Robert A. Carney and Patricia A. Marcini, that they find fulfillment in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we present you these petitions as well as all those prayers that each of us are holding in our hearts, trusting that your will be done. We ask this as well as Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
and lead us to eternal lands, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world, and have arranged the changes of times and seasons. Before men in your own image and set humanity over the whole world and all of its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as a joyful celebration, be acclaimed. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome then into the light of Christ. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not in our sins, but in the faith, and graciously grant our peace and union in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Salt each other's silence.
The body of Christ.
yet consumed, O Lord, in this divine sacrifice, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all time, may profit us for salvation. Christ's love.
Amen. Amen.